New York Mets vs. Miami Marlins. The New York Mets 2024 season got off to a dreadful start, but after the appearance of a now-beloved character, things have been going well, with the team winning 7 of their past 10 games, putting them in the third wildcard spot in the NL. After early struggles, it's the Mets lineup leading the way as they rank 10th in baseball and total offense, but with the rotation struggling to the 23rd best ERA in the league, they need to find that consistency if they want to be considered an elite team in the National League. The Miami Marlins have seemingly continued their endless rebuild in 2024, and while there's been bright spots, their 19-31 home record just isn't good enough as they sit dead last in the National League in 2024. Unfortunately for Miami, there's very positives to take away from the 2024 season, with the lineup ranking 25th in all of baseball, while the rotation has the 27th best ERA, with many question marks over the present and the future of this team. Despite the clear gulf in class between these two teams, the record has been very tight in recent times, with the head-to-head mark sitting at 5-5 in their past 10, with the Marlins having a tight 4-3 record in 7 meetings this season. Last time Luis Severino saw the mound against the Marlins, it resulted in a dominant 7 innings of 1-run ball in the 3-2 victory, and with the Mets not losing a road series in their past 4, expect them to bounce back and tie this series up at 1 each. My team pick is New York minus 1.5 runs. The first game in this series saw runs aplenty, with the over sitting at 5-2 in their 7 meetings this series, as those games combined to average over 10 runs per game in those outings. For the Mets, the over sits at 6-4 in their past 10 overall games, with the team scoring over 5 runs a game in that time, and for the Marlins the over is 6-3-1 in that same time, allowing 5 runs a game in that time, so like game 1, expect this to be an offensive explosion for both teams. Take over 8 runs. Philadelphia Phillies vs. Pittsburgh Pirates. Philadelphia is 6-2-3-5 overall this season. They are in first place in the National League East Division. They are 8 games ahead of the Braves for the divisional lead. The Phillies are 2.5 games ahead of the Guardians for the best record in baseball. They have lost 3 of their last 4 games coming into Saturday. The Pirates are 4-9-4-8 overall this season. Pittsburgh is in third base in the National League Central Division. They are 6 games back of the Brewers for first place in the division. The Pirates are also a half game back of the Mets and Diamondbacks for a wild card spot. The Pirates have won 5 straight games coming into Saturday. Pittsburgh has also won 7 of their last 8 games. The Pirates have been on a heater over the past 2 weeks, and I think that continues on Saturday. They have won 7 of their last 8 games coming into this game. Pittsburgh will be coming off of their walk-off victory and momentum will be high. They will be starting Luis L. Ortiz, who has an ERA of 3.41 when he pitches at home. The Phillies have struggled recently as they have lost 3 of their last 4 games. I think that continues on Saturday as they are starting Christopher Sanchez. He has an ERA of 5.54 on the road. Take the Pirates minus 1.5 runs. The two starting pitchers are both susceptible to allowing multiple runs. This will be a high-scoring game with the Phillies' elite offense. The Pirates have been playing well recently and are in strong form. The home crowd will back them against their in-state rival, and this will be an offensive showdown. Take the over 8.5 runs. Cincinnati Reds vs. Washington Nationals. Cincinnati dropped their last game before the All-Star break, falling to Miami 3-2. Cincinnati finished with 4 hits on the day, as no one was able to log multiple hits at the plate. Ellie De La Cruz logged both RBIs and added a home run. Nick Lodolo got the start, and over 4.2 innings he allowed 2 runs on 3 hits while striking out 4. As of this time, Washington hasn't announced who they expect to take the mound first on Friday. The Nationals sit right around the bottom 10, holding an ERA of 4.15. Washington has tossed stronger at home, dropping their ERA to 3.97 and averaging nearly 4 strikeouts per walk issued. However, the Nats have been a little more erratic under the lights. After a weak June, the Nationals have carried that trend into July, as they are currently sporting a 5.21 ERA and a 5-9 record. Washington has struggled with hitters in scoring position, and their bottom 5 hits allowed has only exacerbated this metric. They have done a solid job in terms of limiting home runs, but the bottom 10 strikeout rate has often seen many foes finding success at the plate. Take Cincinnati money line. As of this writing, the Reds haven't announced who will take the mound on Friday. As it stands, the Reds pitching staff sits right outside the top 10 in overall ERA at 3.82. They have tossed better on the road, with the ERA dropping to under 3.50, and Cincinnati holds a winning road record. they have been a bit more hittable under the lights, but they hold their strongest BBK ratio of any split. Over the first half of July, the pitching staff has been strong, holding a 3.62 ERA. Currently, the Reds are sitting right outside the top half of the league in strikeouts per 9 innings pitched, and they have fallen to the bottom 10 in walks issued. The key for the bullpen here will lie in their ability to command their pitches and keep the Nationals guessing at the plate. Cincinnati enters this series averaging 4.45 runs per game, which lands them at 14th in the league. The Reds have struggled at the plate as they sit 26th in collective batting average. They have hit slightly better on the road, but home runs and extra base hits have been less frequent. On the plus side, Cincinnati is hitting their best under the lights this season. After hitting better than .240 for the first half of July, Cincinnati will hope that strong batting continues post-All-Star break. The troubles for the offense stem from the high strikeout rate. At current, the Reds are 25th in strikeout rate, which has made it more difficult for them to drive runs home. On the plus side, they've climbed into the top half of the league in both home runs and extra base hits. Take over 8.5 runs. In their last game, the Rangers lost 9-1 to the Orioles on Friday, July 19th. Texas trailed 4-0 after the first inning and secured their only run in the second inning. Nathaniel Lowe hit a solo homer for the only run. Nathan Eovaldi pitched 5 innings and he allowed 6 earned runs in the loss. The Orioles have been red hot when they face the Rangers this season. They are 4-1 against Texas, and I think that trend will continue on Saturday. The Rangers are hitting just .230 against them, and they have hit the second fewest amount of doubles. Texas is starting Max Scherzer, who has pitched well in short stint this year, but the Rangers' lack of offense is concerning to me. Baltimore will do enough to grab the win, especially behind the arm of Grayson Rodriguez. Baltimore has a road record of 7-2 when he has started. This should be another easy for the Orioles, who are chasing the best record in the American League. Take the Orioles minus 1.5 runs. On Saturday, the Orioles will start Grayson Rodriguez. The right-handed pitcher is 1-1-4 this season with an ERA of 3.88. Rodriguez has started 17 games with his last game coming against the Yankees on July 13th. He threw 5 innings, and he allowed 6 runs and 8 hits in the 6-1 loss. The Orioles are 1-2-5 when Rodriguez has started. Baltimore is 7-2 when he has also started on the road. Rodriguez has an ERA of 4.59 when pitching on the road. He has started 6 games against the American League West Division where he holds an ERA of 4.81. The Orioles have scored the 4th most runs this season while Ether are hitting .253 from the plate, which ranks 9th best. Baltimore has earned the 4th most hits, and they have hit the most home runs. The Orioles are hitting .252 this season on the road. They are hitting .238 in the month of July. Baltimore is also hitting .263 in their 5 games against the Rangers. On Saturday, the Rangers will start Max Scherzer. The right-handed pitcher is 1-2 this season with an ERA of 2.96. He has started 5 games this year with his last outing coming against the Astros where he pitched 4 innings and he gave up 1 run and 4 hits in the no decision. The Rangers are averaging just 3 runs per game when Scherzer starts. Texas is 3-2 when he has started this season. He has an ERA of 2.38 when pitching at home. Scherzer also holds an ERA of 2.57 in 4 games against the American League. The offense for the Orioles is one of the best in the sport, as they have hit the most home runs in the league. They are also hitting above .260 against the Rangers. But Texas has a poor offense as they are averaging just 3 runs per game. Texas will struggle to score in this game as Baltimore will blow out the Rangers. Take under 8.5 runs.